My heart is troubled. I have published a summa, and thereby given the world a way to manage their businesses through a double-entry bookkeeping. But still, I feel there are limits to the information that can and should be provided in a set of general-purpose financial statements.
Perhaps you could add information about financial statement line items.
Or maybe some information about the entity being reported on.
How about past events and current conditions and circumstances that have not yet been recognized?
All great ideas. We must write this down.
How does a boy from Borgo San Sepulcro move to Venice to study mathematics, then decides to be a Franciscan friar writing books, satisfying his desire? Well, the word got around, the guy was really smart, and he published a book giving accounting its humble start. The Summa de Arithmetica, it gave the man his fame, and the world got to know his name. What's your name, friar?
Luca Pacioli. My name is Luca Pacioli, and there's a lot more that has to be done for these statements to be great.
Luca Pacioli, Luca Pacioli.
The users want a better view.
Users want a better view.
What's in
these statements? Why don't you add some disclosures? Oh, Luca Pacioli, Luca Pacioli. Need to fill in the blanks. In the statements, there's a lot that's missing. On the
your name, friar?
Luca Pacioli.
Leonardo, have you seen the book Luca Pacioli wrote on accounting?
Yes, the man is a genius, not only in math, but in other fields as well. And yet, I feel as if financial statements could use more information.
What about line items, Signore da Vinci?
Yes, of course. Rather than just put the item on the page, you could have information to explain more about what it really meant.
So why not invite Pacioli to meet you in Milan to offer your help?
Perhaps. But who am I kidding? I am no genius. I am but a mere Renaissance man. But would it be so terrible if I had some small amount of genius?
If I were a genius, I could give more information about certain line items. Nature, location, and quality. These affect asset utility. If I were a genius, I'd know how to tell them more about financial instruments. I could describe the potential for credit or the non-performance risk. I'd give the conditions of equity instruments issued by the entity and changes in accounting policies. I'd give a breakdown of line items when they combine things that really aren't the same for cash flows, risks, and other accounting. If I were a genius, I could give the user some alternatives for measurements and how lines relate to other lines. If I were a genius.
Welcome to Milan, Pacioli. It is an honor to meet a man of your genius.
And it is an honor to meet a man of your vision, Leonardo. So, you feel we can make financial statements more useful by providing some footnotes?
I do.
Like what?
Well, to begin with, let's tell the users about the entity itself.
I see. So a user can put the financial numbers in proper context for understanding.
Precisely.
The entity and what it does for a living.
Advantages, privileges, even restrictions.
All transactions with related parties.
We must tell users about all these things.
Primary activities may be prominent. Some other tasks may not be so apparent. When complex transactions are more than they seem, we must tell users about all these things.
Some entities operate without limits. Some may be limited by some restrictions. Those who gain from government subsidies. We must tell users about all these things.
Breakdown of the legal entities that make up the group. We simply must tell users about these things, and then they will be so glad.
Thanks for allowing us time to discuss financial statement disclosures with you. As always, you've been an inspiration, Lisa.
Just remember, there are a number of circumstances that can affect an entity's future cash flows, even though they've not yet affected anything in the statements.
But it will be difficult to provide information about how past and current events could affect those future cash flows.
But that information is critical. Please do not give up, Pacioli. Goodbye.
It won't be easy, but there are ways. You can try the future to reveal when you give more details about the conditions. There are events which may give the users a clue, such as litigation, or commitments, or uncertainties too. Don't stop providing them data. The users can see in the future, describe dependencies and volatility, so they can process and make predictions. You just can't say too much. Tell them all you can think of to say. Do what you have to do to ensure that they know that the financials
Congratulations, Pacioli, you did it! You made these financial statements even better by adding proper disclosures, and they're ready for delivery tomorrow!
Thank you, Leonardo. We must not let our guard down. There are limitations to the value of these disclosures.
How so?
The information must be relevant and worth the cost to obtain.
True, and certain information, improperly presented, could actually create adverse effects.
There's always room for improvement.
But that can wait. It's time to celebrate. The financial statements go out tomorrow.
The statements go out tomorrow, but you know there'll be some limitations, such as we'll all have to work tomorrow to ensure the benefits are worth all the costs.
You must always consider adverse fallout
when we tell them just what they have to say.
Problems. cash flows, but you'll know.
Investors and lenders and other creditors will know what you have to
Pacioli.